Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum dear students and welcome back again. My dear students, today we will learn about active transportation or the active transport of the molecules. My dear students, in our previous videos we were talking about diffusion and osmosis. These two phenomena, they are basically the example of the passive transport. And in the diffusion and osmosis, what we have studied that the in these two phenomena, molecules move from the higher concentration to the lower concentration down the concentration gradient. The molecules move automatically, passively from the higher concentration to the lower concentration. This is a kind of passive transportation, but the active transport is totally opposite to the passive transport. In the case of active transport, molecules or the ions, they move from the lower concentration to the higher concentration against the concentration gradient. My dear students, the molecules, if they need to move against the concentration gradient, they need energy in it, and that energy is provided by the ATP, that is adenosine triphosphate, that is basically a product of respiration. My dear students, in this picture, we are going to have the concept and the idea about the active transportation. In this picture, as you can see in the right box, the concentration of the molecules is high, and in the left box, the concentration of the molecule is very low. But these molecules need to move against the concentration gradient. They need to move from the lower concentration to the higher concentration against the concentration gradient, and in this case they need energy, and that energy is provided by ATP. That ATP is a product of respiration. In the case of the living things, in the cell membrane of the plant and the animals, in the cell membrane there are pumps present. There are pumps present in the cell membrane, and these pumps basically actively pump the molecules from the lower concentration to the higher concentration. My dear students, I hope that you have got the concept and the idea about the active transportation. To understand this example, let's have a look on the movement of the molecules or the movement of the ions from the soil into the root hair cells of the plants against the concentration gradient. Let's have a look. Plants need different minerals in different quantities. The most of the plants, they need nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium, NPK. Nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium in a very large amount. My dear students, they are required in a very large amount to a plant, but in the soil their concentration is very low. As you can see in this picture, in the soil the concentration of nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium is very low as compared to the cells of the roots. And in this case, they are transported actively inside this root hair cell and along the root cortex, and they then comes into the xylem and are transported to the other parts of the plants. My dear students, in the soil, these minerals or the ions, they present in the form of they are dissolved in the water, and as they come in contact with the surface cell membrane, on the cell membrane, as I told you in the earlier, that there are different kinds of pumps present. They pump these minerals actively inside this root hair cell, and that minerals then transported to the other parts of the roots, and they ultimately comes in the xylem vessels, and they are transported to the other parts of the plants. My dear students, in some cases the minerals are present in higher concentration as compared to the inner side of the root. They are present in the soil in a higher concentration. In this case, they move passively inside the root hair cells and they come to the xylem vessels, passing through this root cortex, and they are transported to the other parts of the plant. My dear students, in case of human beings, from the small intestine, from the ileum, glucose is transported actively to the other parts of our body. Let's have a look how it is transported. Glucose, which is the product of digestion of carbohydrates, that glucose has a relatively low concentration in our ileum, and that needs to be transported to the other parts of our body, and the other parts of our body have relatively high concentration of glucose as compared to the concentration of glucose which is present in the ileum. So this is another example of the active transportation. My dear students, in this picture, ileum is basically the last part of our small intestine, and in the ileum, almost all types of digestive nutrients are reabsorbed. And my dear students, ileum have a small finger-like projections which are called villi, and these cells, they actively transport glucose from the intestine to the blood, and that blood takes or transport to the glucose to other parts of our body. My dear students, I hope you have got the concept and idea about the active transportation, and with the different examples we have understood about it. My dear students, in the next lesson we will discuss about the summary of the whole unit. Till then, take care of yourselves and people around you. Allah Hafiz.